Und jetzt machen wir Übergang zu Mrs. Velvet Goldmine. Please, du hast das Wort.
Hallo.
Und du sollst auf Englisch alles machen, weil unsere Lisbeth, unsere Gastin, ist aus Niederland. Sie kann inzwischen Deutsch gut verstehen, meine Deutsch sogar. Aber sie findet besser, wenn sie kriegt mehr alles mit, wenn sie auf Englisch dabei hört. Und ich verstehe auch dein Englisch. Okay. Du bist jetzt dran.
So, it's my turn. Hello, I'm Mrs. Velvet Goldmine, as Vladimir already said. And well, you have to bear me for the next hour or so. First of all, I would like to explain a little bit what I'm doing. I have two parts in this talk. The first one will be a call to action. The second one, I will be showing you some works of mine, actually, quite a few. You're going to be dead by this. By the end of the hour. So I'm trying to switch to my computer now. This is getting excited. I might get lost. If not, I'm coming back. Here we are. Am I still in the meeting? I'm coming back. Okay, here I am.
Du bist ganze Zeit da.
Ah, too bad. Where am I? I couldn't find it actually at the moment.
Jetzt sind wir in deinem Computer.
Can you see my call to action?
Yes.
Okay, so I have the, here I am.
Jetzt, ja, genau.
So, I have this question to everybody. If you could change the world, what would be your idea? Don't take reference to anybody, to anyone you heard of. You read a book or you studied something. Forget all of it. It's just about you. What would you do if you had the power to change the world? I know it's hard. It might be a lot because we know the world is as it is. So, this question, if I could change the world, I would. If I could change the world, I would. Put in your ideas.
Ladi.
Ich bin hier in der Chat. Ich höre hier.
And again, if I could change the world, I would. If I could change the world, what would I do? So, it goes on forever, forever, forever. Do I have any ideas? I mean, if you were the only person on the planet who could change the world, what is important? What is most important? So, this is basically my call to action. You can take it home, make your homework, and have your ideas about it. What would you do? You don't have to answer. I'm just putting this, your thought, your ideas. Take it home, sleep about it, write it down. I know it's difficult. So, any questions? Nobody? You still there? Still
Where
there?
would I do my idea?
Pardon?
Where would I do my idea?
There's a download on the website as
Ah ja,
PDF,
yes.
or just
Okay.
write it down, whatever, you
Yes,
know.
okay.
So maybe one time you give it to me or not, but just exactly where do I stand, what do I want?
Man kann vielleicht in der Chat Fenster hier schreiben, oder?
I don't see the chat fenster at the moment. We're
Okay,
talking.
kannst du danach sehen, ja.
I can see it later. Yeah. So that's we started with a bang, I suppose. Any more questions? No, everybody is silent. So I might turn to part two about some of my works. I consider myself a surrealist, fluxist, whatever. So for those who don't know already what I'm doing, I sometimes even don't know what I'm doing, but this is my work. So this is the first work. Let me please introduce myself. This is the gravestone for the art, which was at Kunstverein Familie Montes, the last show in the old hall, where I did this ground installation. You see all rubble and quite destroyed. And there were even some people walking in it because they didn't realize it was an artwork. So this was the next step for Montes when we occupied the new place. This is a package from a computer which I turned into a some friendly monster, I call it. You see here the eyes, the nose, the mouth, and a little mustache. And we occupied the place in order to secure, we had a new wall, a new hall. Excuse me. So it even wears a scarf. the next one is The Empire Strikes Back. Some twig I found in the forest and a piece of textile. I worked with sand and acrylics and a pair of shoes, a lady's shoes, all in brown. So Mother Nature mostly. The next one, I'm going a bit faster, so we can maybe have time to go back. These are mostly the found pieces I worked with. I found this one at a building site, actually, a broken piece of lumber. And it was had this perfect shape of a gun, including the bullets. Maybe more than actually is in a magazine, but anyway. And I put this stencil on it. It says fragile because it's broken. It must have been fragile at some point. Even though it looks a bit dangerous, it must be fragile. Next one, please. This is an installation I did in a gallery around the corner here in Bockenheim. There die Das, also the women's theme. We just started very orderly on with the shoes and the objects and just the way it is in an exhibition. And I turned it into an increasing state of disorder, as you see, towards the end. The whole place was wrecked. And I called it small change because every day I went to the gallery and added a little change, like maybe the rose, maybe the torn papers of the speech of the opening, whatsoever. Here is, I started with the end. Here's the beginning, very orderly, as you see, the pedestal, the shoes, the objects in the background. And yes, probably the object. No. Oh, excuse me, I forgot to take this one out. Here's the objects, inverse, converse, universe, three round-shaped objects depicting the female universe with glitter in it and black. This is The structure is textile and sand, so it gets a little bit more solid, and put it on a round canvas, which I actually had made. A carpenter did that for me. So, another aspect of my work is installation land art. I went around Nidder Park, which is here to my back actually, and adorned some things I thought were worth it, and like this football playing ground with the textiles I'm working. Usually you saw on the object before, this is how they look. I got it from the manufacturer. It's a bandaging material. And I called them, do you have anything? Oh, yes, we have lots of it. And they sent me about 20 kilos. I can supply hospitals, actually. So this is how it looks in the original state, the virgin state, so to speak. And I did it for the structures. You see the trees in the back, and the pattern of this, how do you call it, the goal. And then the structures of the textiles. I went there very early in the morning, so nobody could see what I'm doing, and not call the police. Anybody doesn't call the police. This is the next one. When I found a tree for Frankfurt, this was for Frankfurt Kunstsommer, I found this tree, and actually the city of Frankfurt is absolutely protecting the trees. And I put this huge screw into the tree to mark it. And I thought it was worth to put a bandage around it. So nobody liked it too much, and not from the city of Frankfurt, actually. They didn't want to see a hurt tree, but so that's how it is. A next one from Pulp, actually. I forgot to tell you, this is Pulp, a pop-up land art project. And I did this on a bridge, which is named after an artist in Braunheim. And this is the Petristeg. So I thought, nice idea to install my art there during summer and let it just flow free in the wind. I even had a school class while I was photographing. So, am I going too fast or am I going too slow? Is it okay?
It's okay.
Is it too much for anybody?
No.
Lucky you. One of my other work is Richterstuhl.
Die hatte Oil and Gas.
Some from Oil and Gas might remember it. I put this chair, in Germany, stool is like the same, you might call stool in English. So I did this chair in brown to look like the original object. And you see here the offerings, and here, and here, and here. Everything in this exhibition was looking like the original brown product. And this is, I don't know what it was, but this is licorice, and I did some pastries in letter form that said O-H-S-H-I-T. And you have it all on the pedestals, and they are being served to the audience. And I even made a Stuhlgang, which means I took the people around in a lecture or whatever, around this, the object. Here it is again. One more ladies' shoes fashion. This was in a studio place in Rödelheim. This is dealing with the German-Franco wars and actually how it turned into a fashion craze. You see the German flag, some of the French flag, some colors, and even brown for the German past. The shoes in brown. So I combined, I like to combine two national flags in color. I did this recently for some other thing. I think it's quite nice to overcome difficulties in an installation, so to speak. And this is also again the textiles. They are always these bandage materials, they are always behind the scene, so to speak. Always in the pictures, I worked into it. Even if you don't see them, trust me, they are there. And here, the three crosses, dealing with the topic of nature, the torn textiles here, the bandages, they're all torn and falling to the floor. And you see here the elks. The crucified nature. This was, I don't know, was it 2012 or I keep forgetting, 2010 in a basement in Bornheim.
Erlösung hieß die Ausstellung.
Erlösung, redemption. Yes, 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 yes. And here it is again, my obsession. I'd like, if I could change the world, I'd like to shave the world. You see it here, a plate, a Chinese plate. How do you call it? A cutter for like cucumbers or potatoes. You can peel with it. I don't know the English word. And here you have this protecting thing for fruits, like, I don't know, some exotic fruits and a softball. Combined, so we are shaving the planet. Like the, I might cite the Rolling Stones, after all, it was you and me. It all looks quite harmless, but it isn't. And here it is, the exhibition in Eulengasse. Excuse me, Vladimir, excuse me, Harald. Once upon a time, here is to the left you see the Shave the Planet, the white rabbit. In the back you see a German topic, you can't really see it. Three pens in the flag of the German color, and one is escaping. They are under this cake cover. And one is escaping, like the wall is falling. There's a hole in the wall, and the black one escaped. It's running away from east, from the east. And the east is supposed to be to the right, and the west to the left, like it is in real life, or at least in our conception. And here we have homage to Andy Warhol. It is a work, I have a Campbell soup and a crochet soup bowl and a spoon. Quite useless if you want to eat the soup, but it's art. And I dedicated this to Andy Warhol. The first piece is in New York. I had this in an exhibition in New York. And I took it there. The works were supposed to be packed, and I put it in a care package I took to America. So I reversed the process. After the Second World War, the Americans were sending care packages to Germany, and now I'm taking my reference back to New York. And I even took this tin to the MoMA and put it right in front of the Campbell Soups of Andy Warhol. I didn't get arrested. I got away with it. Taking a metal object into the MoMA. I don't know if they still do it, if they still let people in after my visit. Here we have Karl Marx. This is my favorite, one of my favorites. I found this book on Schönhauser Allee, East Berlin. Karl Marx in special offer, The Capital. I thought, okay, I can't do any more art than this. It's art in itself. Selling Karl Marx in on special offer, reduced price. There's nothing more I can do. So I put it on a plate and to serve it to people with a nice little, as it is supposed to be. In the 70s, we used to have this in our grandma's places, the white, whatever it is, paper stuff. And this one actually is from the old hall of Familie Montes. And we even have the match somebody threw away. And I took it out of the installation. We saw it in the beginning, the very first one. This is from the site, and I stole it from there. And here we have the Campbell Soup as it is, in full bloom, so to speak. And one more thing. I'll be your mirror. It's a makeup box, a powder, makeup powder box. I put colors in, and you can see not yourself, but nature. And I did this for Gustav Metzger's Remember Nature thing. He had a worldwide call for people. Turning the world into an art museum for one day. So he's doing the self-destructing art. It's not my English speaking day, but anyway, I hope we get along. So next one, please. This is plastic. I have this plastic bottles and a little bit of dirt on the top swimming around here, floating around here, and sitting on the seabed actually. And it's just there. In English it's called plastic, in German it's called plastic, and it in German the plastic has two meanings. The plastic, like in the bottles and in the rubbish, and also for sculpture. So you might call it a sculpture. I like to call it an installation. So this is the heart, the state of the heart. It is, I don't know how big, 1.50 meters, a crocheted object. You can also wear it, put it over your head, and it's a poncho when it's cold. I already did so, as some of you might know. And it has obviously a hole in the middle. We don't know how that happened, but it's there. And here's the latest state of the heart. It's a plastic, rubber heart, which surprisingly sits on an X-Lyser. How it got there, nobody knows. And here we got projection space. As artists, we know we, let me say, evoke all kinds of projections towards us. And I thought, okay, I have a blank space and have it signed here. The artist's name is Projektionsfläche. And you can project anything you like on it. We see what happens, and some already did, as we see. So, and this is, yes, I'm a bitch. Did I miss a letter? No, it's a reference to Yoko Ono. And she said, yes, I'm a witch, because they called her a bitch. And here we are, two found objects, which I work often. I find like this on a trash heap somewhere in the street. And so, okay, this is my baby, exactly the small one. A performance, one of my performances for Easter. I went to the Kirchplatz, which is near to where I live, and performed women for Easter. We actually got thrown out, because security, when you need it, it's never there, but you don't know how fast they came in. When I and the photographer were there and took pictures. So, we were kicked out and came back with permission later and did it again. But it was an honor. I never got kicked out by a security before. So I really loved it. Ah, and here the one thing I won't let you get past it, my knitting performance in the MoMA. I also didn't get kicked out. The security came and said, asked me, what are you doing? And I explained my chaos, and he let me get away with it. So from then on, I'm a MoMA artist, and that's that. Thank you for your attention. I hope I didn't torture you too much. Oops, yeah.
Die Schirmfreigabe stoppen, da oben, der rote Knopf stoppen.
Ah, ja, okay. So, jetzt bin ich wieder da. I'm back. Okay.
Super. Eine große Überblick über, was du letzte Zeit gemacht hast oder eine gute Zeit gemacht hast, ja.
Ja. Mhm. Und das ist noch nicht alles. Ich hätte euch...
Klar.
Foltern können bis in alle Ewigkeit. Ja, jemand fragen?
Soll ich auch fragen wieder?
Ja, eine.
Ja, ich habe das gedacht, als ich das alles gesehen habe, jetzt viele Sachen kenne ich, aber ich habe zuerst mal das gedacht jetzt, als ich das jetzt diesen Überblick gesehen habe. Ich habe mir die Frage gestellt, ich habe zuerst gesehen, bei alles, was du machst, hast du viel Humor. Aber du hast aber eine feine Ironie dazu. Da habe ich gedacht, meine Frage die an dir ist, bist du eher eine Depressiv oder eher eine Optimist-Künstlerin? Also als Künstlerin meine ich.
Ja, ich bin hoffnungslos optimistisch. Ich würde es mal so sagen, ja.
Jetzt weil, bitte auf Englisch für die. Ich kann nicht Englisch.
Do I speak English? Yo, of Elizabeth. Yeah. Ah, okay, sorry.
I understood the remark. I understood.
Yeah. Considering the state of the planet and whatever, you have to be optimistic. Yeah, it's a must. So,
guck mal, der Haar gibt's doppelt heute.
Was für eine Ehre, ist ja auch der Vorstand. He's the chairman of the board. He deserves to be there twice. So.
Yeah, I'm here in the courtyard of Eulengasse. As you see here, you see our big tree here in the courtyard.
And I'm sitting today here is on. Not thine presentation. Today is not thine presentation. Have you questions?
For instance, I'm without any questions. Perhaps I'll come back with some remarks later.
Okay.
And what about the others, Arturo?
Arturo?
I'm here. I will ask about the exhibition, the work that you make with this bandages.
No? Yes.
And how difficult was for you to do this work with the trees? Whether you need a lighter, or did you make it alone, or did you make it with some people? How it was? Because you said that you make it the beginning of the day, really early.
Yeah, mostly I went really early, but difficult. I set myself some standards, and that was I would only throw it over the branches of the trees, and not use any props or like steps or climb on a tree. I wrapped into the bandages and threw it over the trees, over the branches. But I didn't do that in the end because it might kick some leaves or whatever off, and I didn't want to do damage. So, but sometimes it was really cold. It was really cold. And sometimes it was really hot. And it was a very interesting. People came up to me, oh, what are you doing? The birds are getting caught up in the material. And I said, no, I'm taking it down, because that was one more point. I didn't want to leave it there, so it might get vandalized. They might burn it, or, as it happened with other artists' work. They set fire to it, and textile material that invites people. Mm-hmm. So to put a torch to it, and this is not what I wanted. Exactly not, just the opposite.
Mm-hmm. I see.
And I did this over the course of a year, so to see the changes in nature, but also different places, everything different places. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And sometimes people came, they saw it as a high-rise building, and people came, oh, we saw it from our balcony, we have to see what's going on. Yeah, it's really, really nice sometimes. And one woman came, it was the 6th of August, and she had to remind everybody of Hiroshima. So she put she had written something and came to me, and she saw it somewhere and came running, and, you know, it's the day of Hiroshima. Yes, I know. How can we put it here? No more war, no more war. Yeah, I liked it. You know, the interaction with the people that gets a little bit lost in the documentation. I can write it. Mm-hmm. So.
In some of your installations, Velvet, I see female topics or backgrounds. Mm-hmm.
I can't hear you, Ariane. Sorry.
Deine Ton ist ausgegangen, Karianne. Am Anfang war da, dann ist ausgegangen. Guck mal. Nee, etwas mit deinem Ton ist ausgegangen.
Oh.
Und jetzt?
Jetzt ist da. It's there. Yeah.
Okay. In some of your installations, I see female topics or background. But would you say how big is your part of female art and how important is it for you?
It's very important to me to make a statement. I am female, and I see the world from my angle. And I try, maybe I can change it. I don't know. We see it in 50 years, if I could do something about it. Yeah, I thought this from the beginning when I chose my alias. I could have left it like neutral, but I put... the misses on purpose in front of you. So everybody knows I'm a woman, you know, be afraid of me. Yes, I am a bitch. So, yeah. And yeah, I'm often, it's getting even more in time because I'm not working from the studio, I'm working from home. And I raid the kitchen for things like the slicer. It's getting worse by the minute, so to speak. And I want to make a statement. I'm not doing this in the clouds or somewhere. Yes, we are there. We are more than 50% of mankind and we are underrepresented. So please hear us. This is what we are. So.
Okay. I like your installations with the bitch.
Yes. It's all found pieces. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, not found. The bigger one I bought.
The used is found and the new one is bought.
Yes, the older one I bought, and the young one, you can only find your children, you can't buy them. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I have a new installation I'm working on. It's the female universe. It's getting even worse, which is to be shown next year. We still find, in the process of finding a time slot due to Corona, everything is mixed and muddled up. So next year, you all come to the exhibition. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Normalerweise hast du, ich kenne deine Arbeit schon lange, normalerweise hast du bei jeder Installation oder bei jeder Gegenstand, die du als Kunst deklarierst, einen Text, eine Erklärung, eine Zusammenfassung, eine Situation, eigentlich ein situative Text, die du immer schreibst, nenne ich so gerade. Mhm. Ist für mich immer ein Teil der Arbeit und ich finde immer schade, wenn man das nicht zusammen da sieht. Wenn ich diese lese und sage ich, wann fängst du zu arbeiten, wann hörst du auf? Weil ich habe den Eindruck, dass du die ganze Zeit in Arbeit bist. Du kommst in die Eule Gasse, ich weiß nicht, ob du gerade bei Arbeit bist oder nicht bei Arbeit bist. Wie siehst du das an?
Ja, still in English or German?
Bitte übersetze, ein bisschen zusammenfassen.
Yeah. I think artists are always at work. I can't separate it. I say, okay, now I'm not working and now I'm working. I couldn't even tell you. Maybe you know more about it when I'm at work because you see it from the outside. I see it from the inside and I can't always judge what happens. Am I working or not? Is this a performance or not? So, yeah.
It's like an architect is looking with his architect's eyes in the surrounding, and seeing something like that. A lawyer is reading a text, and when he's reading that text, he's looking at paragraphs and paragraphs of. Yeah.
That's true. Yeah. That's your occupation or your passion that changes your life. Mm-hmm. And you see the world from that angle.
Yeah.
That's how it is, yeah.
But it's it depends on your attitude towards your profession and the art that you are producing. And so it's for you, it's not a duty, it's something very easy to do, or
it's a pleasure.
Yeah,
we separate between like they call it in German the bread job that pays the rent and your passion. And yeah, you might be lucky if you can blend the two, or if your passion is your job. But in Germany, everything, it's not work, I like to do it. It has such a negative taste to it. I mean, like you hate 8 or 10 or 11 or 12 hours a day when you have to work. And I think it's a waste of your lifetime. If you don't like it, you don't do it. You look for something else. If you have to have a bread job, there's more than enough work to do in the world. But as an artist,
it's like that. You have to choose your bread to eat, and so bread job could be white bread or smoothie.
A smoothie? No, not a smoothie. You could frighten me away with that. Show me a smoothie and it's like Polanski's garlic sausage. don't, it's serious. We are talking about art.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that brings us to the topic, why don't they buy our art, huh?
Oh, yeah. So now you are touching political, art political theme, yeah? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like somebody asked me at one time, it's about a year or two ago, why can't you live from your art? And I said, because people like you don't buy it. And he went pale and had all kinds of color changes, like these LED lamps, you know. But that's how it is, you know. So, performance finished?
Do you have a question, Lisbeth?
Lisbeth, your sound, yeah.
Yes, my sound. Sorry, I said no. I don't have a question. I'm intrigued by your work and yourself. And that's the thing. You never stop thinking like an artist, and so recognizable. You are an artist always, day and night. It just goes on and on and on. That's something that's very recognizable. And I like how you combine it all in your work. And I really can see it with the pictures you showed us. And when I heard about Vladimir told us about the text that has to go with your work, I can imagine it works even better. So that's a thing I really like. And I thank you for sharing it, because that's great.
Oh, thank you. It's my pleasure.
Yeah, so I don't really have I don't really have a question. But I like the way that you work and how you tell it to us, and I can see you almost feel the way you do it. So.
Okay, yeah, but I think this is the only way to do it. You know, if you have to think, oh, what am I going to do today? Do I knit something or no, it's raining, it's too hot, then I don't start in the first place.
No.
You're not an artist then, yeah.
No, no.
Yeah. So you have to be on a mission.
Yeah, yeah, yes, I think so, yes. Especially when you are unstoppable. You would just go on and on.
Oh. Yeah, I'm explaining what I'm doing, you know. And these are only little pieces. As Vladimir said, I didn't include the text, you know. That would be too much. Yeah.
Okay. Velvet, do you know the PCA?
Who's that? Can you eat it?
No, perhaps, I don't know. The post-Coronian art, PCA.
We're still in it.
We're in it, but we have to think about the post-Coronian art.
I am doing, do I we? Have a project.
Do you have a project for that yet?
At least a suggestion so far. But I don't like to jump around, so to speak, on the Corona subject.
Okay.
I don't know. We're still in it. We don't know where it gets to. It looks quite good. I don't know what to make of it.
Okay. Okay.
I wish it was over, and then I could start my project.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is there anything, any plans, or what is it?
No, but as the Corona theme is around us, and which is very central in our lifetime now, so we have so there are some artists. They integrate it in their art, like Helmut does, about the Corona drawings that he is doing. Yes. And other artists are integrating that theme in their art. And perhaps your art is, in a certain way, it's concept art. And so perhaps you are not such in doing at the same time, so you are more thinking about, and perhaps you are doing it more brainy, and that's why you let the theme a bit far from you.
I don't know. I don't want to give it too much space at the moment. Maybe in retrospect, I'll do something, but we don't know. Maybe it's over and it's forgotten about a year later, and people return to the same old habits. It might change. It might change art, definitely. It changes the artist scene, the cultural scene. It has effects on that. But we don't know what is going to happen. So I'm recording that on my internal hard disk and see maybe in 2 years.
Okay.
What has become of it? Where are the survivors? Where are the how do you call it, the prisoners, the ones that didn't make it? Already see lots of clubs closing. I can't judge that at the moment. I don't know what I'm doing then. Okay.
Ich habe noch wieder eine Lob. Eine Lob. Ich finde auch, dass es sehr authentisch, was du machst, weil es deine, es steht immer, es sind viele Künstler, die man sagen, okay, das ist alles platt oder das ist, habe ich nicht verstanden oder ist unpersönlich. Das kann man bei dir nicht verwende, weil es sehr authentisch und es ist immer deine Meinung dazu, äußerst du, das ist eine Opinion dazu, deine Opinion, deine Verfassung über das Thema, das du wählst. Das finde ich auch sehr authentisch und sehr, manchmal bin ich nicht einverstanden mit deiner Opinion, aber das ist eine andere Frage.
Ich habe gehört, dass du nicht einverstanden doch bist.
Ja, aber das
doch immer durch.
Genau. Oder musst du nicht gar nicht dich durchsetzen? Ist da, einfach du äußerst deine Opinion. Ja, das ist schon schön, ja.
Ja, du auch, ja. Ja. Oh, du bist von der Ton ist weg, Vladimir.
Ja, ich habe meinen Ton weggenommen, damit die andere rede jetzt, ja.
Ah, okay.
What about Pelusa?
Du musst dein Mikrofon anschalten, Pelusa, zuerst. Links unter das Symbol der Mikrofone. Drauf drücke. Ist noch an. Ist noch aus. Einmal drücke. Nee, ist nicht.
Links unten?
Links unter dieses Symbol der Mikrofone, wo steht stumm schalten, musst du drauf einmal drauf drücken. Nee.
Ansonsten bleib mir.
Moment.
Du könntest auch an meinen Computer gehen.
Jetzt kannst du reden. Aber funktioniert leider nicht. Man hört dich nicht. Nee. Lauter? Nee. Schade, man hört dich nicht. Wenn du Fragen hast, musst du schreiben auf der Chat-Seite. Hat jemand noch Fragen?
Jay, I have a question. Velvet, I wanted to make a question. I wanted to know about the shoe that you are using all the time in many of your work. What is the meaning of them? No, because for some work had some meaning, but for some other work had other meaning. But we can say that probably there's a global meaning for the shoes and the dresses that you are using on your work.
The shoe is actually the symbol for the women. Mm-hmm. Like these high heels. If there's one image you would use for women, maybe it's the shoe. So I take this as the symbol, like in The Empire Strikes Back, I have this machine gun, as you remember the twig. And the shoe under it. So the shoe, no, sorry, I have the hay fever. the shoe represents women. Mm-hmm. So it's the female universe is like, it connects to the branch above. Yeah. Yeah?
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. So? Anybody more questions?
Ich glaube, Pelusa hätte noch eine Question, aber das klappt leider jetzt nicht. Oh, guck mal, sie hat ein Mikrofon. Ja. Schade, Pelusa. Ja, tut mir leid. Ja, das müssen wir einfach, wenn du morgen wieder dabei bist und dein Mikrofon funktioniert, weil du dann noch ein größeres Mikrofon dabei hast, dann, und Velvet, du bist auch im Gastraum, dann können wir das immer noch beantworten.
Ja, das können wir jederzeit noch mal. Weil ich bin gespannt, was Pelusa zu fragen hat, was die Frage ist.
Ja,
Benutzer, Benutzer, es gibt eine Tastenkombination bei Windows, die man die Mikrofon einschalten und ausschalten. Vielleicht sucht man Tastenkombination einschalten, ausschalten in Google, dann findest du das.
Aber vielleicht macht ihr das danach sozusagen mal alleine, ihr beiden. Und ja, ich wollte dich, Vladimir, fragen, wer ist denn morgen dran?
Morgen dran sind 3 Personen. Mhm. Das ist ein Tag, wo wir 3 Personen haben. Nämlich der Dennis Buckley als Erster um 5 Uhr PM. Danach kommt die Barbara Books mit Zeichnungen, Dennis mit Malerei, Barbara mit Zeichnungen und Pelusa Petzl, die jetzt mit Mikrofonproblemen hat, als Dritte danach, eine Stunde später.
Also, ja. Pelusa, du hast jetzt noch 23 Stunden Zeit, dieses kleine technische Problem zu lösen. Und der Vladimir wird dir sicherlich da unterstützen. Und ansonsten würde ich jetzt einfach mal sagen, Mrs. Velvety Oldmine, herzlichen Dank für deine Präsentation und für diese angeregte Diskussion hinterher wieder an alle Teilnehmenden von heute. Genießt den schönen Sommerabend noch und wir sehen uns wieder in ganz wenigen Stunden auf diesem Kanal.
Das haben wir einen richtigen Marathon daraus gemacht. Ja. Vielen Dank, Velvet. War sehr schön. Das war sehr poetisch mit dir.
Ach, danke. My pleasure. Thanks for the invitation.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.